In this video, I'm going to talk about the clinical prediction rule of Cleland to predict success of a thoracic manipulation for neck pain.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Although cervical spine thrust manipulation has been advocated as an intervention appropriate for the care of patients with neck pain, clinicians must consider the benefits relative to the potential risks, especially vertebral artery insult. For this reason, thoracic manipulation has been shown to be a safe alternative to cervical manipulation. But how do we determine if a patient with mechanical neck pain could benefit from a thoracic manipulation or not? Cleland et al. In the year 2007 have come up with a clinical prediction rule describing several criteria to guide your decision making. However, Cleland tried to test his own CPR 3 years later in a validation study and found that the CPR he found in 2007 was not valid for the new group. For this reason, the clinical value of the CPR is weak. So let's look at the 6 different criteria that are described by the author to predict success with a thoracic manipulation. Number 1, a FAP-Q score of less than 12 points on the physical activity scale. So patients with less fear avoidance beliefs regarding physical activity will rather benefit from thoracic manipulation. Number 2, duration of symptoms of the current neck pain episode for less than 30 days. This makes sense, knowing that manual therapy in general is less effective in the rather chronic population. This is also the strongest predictor for success in the CPR of Flynn et al. That we have presented on this channel a while ago. Number 3, no symptoms distal to the shoulder. Number 4, the patient reports that looking up does not aggravate the symptoms. If a patient does experience pain by looking up and pain distal to the shoulder in point 3, this might be indicative of a subgroup of patients with cervical radiculopathy rather than solely mechanical neck pain. These patients might be more responsive to a different treatment approach. Number 5, cervical extension of less than 30 degrees. And number 6, the patient presents with a diminished kyphosis on the levels T3 to T5. The authors reasoned that item 5 and 6 might be associated with a biomechanical link between the thoracic and the cervical spine. This item also had a moderate reliability of 0.58 if anyone was questioning this item. If 3 or more of those 6 items were present, the positive likelihood for successful thoracic manipulation was at 5.5, which can be considered a moderate increase of success. 4 or more positive items yielded a positive likelihood ratio of 12, which strongly increases chances for success. Be aware though that the confidence intervals were very wide for both outcomes, as this is often the case in clinical prediction rules. Like mentioned in the beginning of the video, cervical manipulation can be an effective treatment option in mechanical neck pain as well, when the patient has a low risk profile for artery dissection. If you want to learn more about the clinical prediction rule for cervical manipulation, click on the video right next to me. Okay, this marks the end of our video. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if you liked it. If you want to see more of us, check us out on other social media channels. For all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more, have a look at our very own assessment ebook or mobile app. Links are in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.